Hi, and welcome back to another episode of Leaving Pfarm, right here on TammyPepperman.org, No Borders Radio at NoBordersRadio.co.uk, and as always, brought to you by Tamworth Web Development. If you would like to donate, please visit us at TammyPepperman.org and click on our Support Us buttons. Every little bit helps. Tonight, I'm having difficulty getting into the Revolution Radio Skype. I'm not sure if any of the producers or anybody's listening, but it's still bubbling, so I'm not on the air. We'll just try to go on and deal with this as best as we can until they get this situation rectified. So, oh, my voice is strained as well. I'm sorry about that, folks. This week has just been amazing. Apparently, the General Council was trying to kill human beings, and they had purchased some doctors to do that with the Ebola virus outbreak. And now the two doctors are dead, and the General Council is under quarantine in Sierra Leone. I'm like, this is these are quite the amazing things that are happening. This is after the Confederacy burned down the manor of Canterbury, the House of Canterbury there. And we'll see what's going on here, because right now, oh, it even stopped dialing into Revolution there. So we'll keep everybody updated on what's going on as well. Lots and lots of stuff happening today, and you know, I made my intentions clear. You choose your side. That's what it's all about. No more pussyfooting around or tiptoeing around or pretending to be anything. Everybody that is marked is already marked. It's not like it was an option after these criminal acts were maintained by the evidence. You did it. You made your bed. Now you're going to lay in it. It doesn't matter if you don't want to lay in it. It's still your bed. You know, and these things are quite profound to see as the merchants are wailing. The, you know, especially the psychiatrists. It's like, holy cow. You know? Talk about leaving the farm. Okay, you were given due process. You were given notice. You know, what do you think leaving the farm, P-F-A-R-M, means? Public law. What do you think that means? It doesn't mean human trafficking. It doesn't mean acting under acts of commerce and private acts. It means that you're going to be held accountable for your works and actions. You chose to do these things, and in so choosing, you will be held accountable for your works. And here we are on Rev. Finally, I was able to dial in freedomslips.com. We are listener-supported radio station. If you'd like to donate, please visit us at www.freedomslips.com and click on our support pages. Every little bit helps. You can also visit us in chat to see what we're missing on our goal. I think the goal is like $1,900 a month. That is what keeps Revolution Radio running. And in this, the heart keeps us on the air. We've got Studio A, we've got Studio B, and then you can catch some downtime on the Hawk's Nest in the middle, right in the middle of the two studios. And Hawk, of course, and his band are, I just love their music. And you can find the archives and listen to the Hawk's Nest also on YouTube. And that's at Revolution Talk Radio on YouTube. And we've changed a couple times on YouTube because, of course, in the years past, we've been attacked by agents and these entities, these bots that go along YouTube videos and, you know, thumb them down or whatever, or get them banned for whatever reason. But those archives are still out there. And the archives are still at freedomslips.com. And there are, you know, you do have access to all of our audios. And in this, we keep a running cache, I guess you could say, at tammypepperman.org. In there you'll find documentation and documents, authorized documents, as well as the audios. And always you'll hear the Sovereign Cat, my co-host. All these things are crazy. Okay, so we've got a lot of bankruptcies we're seeing. Everybody's filing for bankruptcy. They can't do it. All of these different countries. We need our people in there to pick up the citizens as their governments are going away at this time. That way we can ensure that humanity's well-being is being adhered to and protected above all things. This is not national security. It is state security. And everything that is contrary to state security falls under espionage. So, I mean, if you're not with us, you're against us. And it says this in 18 U.S.C. subsection 794. So that being said, again, tonight is, man, it's jam-packed. Let me get over here and we'll see how this new thing works here, because I've been trying to minimize my clicking sounds as per the directives of the director and producer. Let me all know how I'm doing. Let's see here, I can just get it on a rolling scale. The New York Times reported Europe has become an inadvertent underwriter of Al-Qaeda. You can find that over at the New York Times, of course. And it was a very, very interesting article showing that the United States Incorporated has been bankrupt for a very long time. And what happened at the restructure this last time is they got a lot of corporations to finance its venture because it didn't have any more money left. Hello? That's why it filed for bankruptcy. Didn't have any money left to play on. So it says here, I'll make you my partner, talking to the corporations. And you finance me, and it'll be in both of our interests. Now, this last week, I've seen the most profound things because the United States have been followed by corporations jumping on board. And that evidences that that entity is adherent to the public law. So, of course, as long as it's adhering to the public law, it is with immunity and sovereignty. Now, this matter with the Manor of Canterbury being burnt down this week, you better hope that that wasn't a sovereign state. And you're volunteering to assume any and all charges, and that means that if you burn something down, you're going to pay to erect it. It's not going against the backs of humanity to fix what you just did or what you just broke. Heigl does not work under the public law. It's not going to benefit you in any way, shape, or form. You know, we've been experiencing such gnashing of the teeth this week. My goodness. Hateful things. Thankfully, they only irritate me as to my conscience. You're getting real close to altering my heading. You know what that costs. We've got this business to do with these children. I'll say this one more time. I do not stop until all of the children are accounted for in the United States. That means globally. They are not to be trafficked by the United Nations. They're not a product of development. You touch them, and you will be responsible and accountable for every one of your works under the rules of shipping. Now, under 46 U.S.C. 313.25 through 41, and you attorneys, you listen very closely. You are trained in the use of the law. Ignorance of the law is no excuse. Under 46 U.S.C. 313.25 through 41, if you maintain a lien on a public vessel, referring to a human being, you are voluntarily assuming those charges if you get caught. Now, my function was to evidence you, your works. So I graciously volunteered to allow you to do whatever you wanted upon me. And this is what evidenced your works. It's not a presumption. I didn't come in making a claim. I allowed you, with knowledge and intent, to harm me by which to evidence your works. There will be no more of these things. Russia's euro debt outweighs ruble debt. Nice to see. Negotiable instruments shoved up into those holding corporations. And nice to see that shift. No more playing around with that funny money stuff. It's all backed by the attorney now. Wall Street Journal. Unidentified group attacked state offices and killed dozens in China's Xinjiang region. That's just terrible. Terrible to see. I don't know. I don't have any more updates. It's just 13 minutes, but I think that's when I wrote it down. Let me go check and see if there's any further updates to this one, because it was terrible. We saw a couple gas explosions today, and many things going on, and it looks like they're really cannibalizing each other very, very harshly now. I mean, this is government offices attacked, dozens killed in far western China. Deadly violence comes after rioting by unidentified assailants in restive, mostly a Muslim region. A group of assailants launched coordinated attacks on government police buildings in China's far east western Xinjiang region on Monday, leaving dozens of people dead a day before the mostly Muslim area was set to celebrate the end of Ramadan. Oh, that's not only wartime, these are wartime tactics. You're doing this in the name of God? It's also a crime. That also puts you into hell. These are these priests and rabbis and things doing these things. You're not going to get away with these things. We've evidenced these things happening right on the United States Incorporated with Thomas Herbs, Jeff Herbs, and how the priest was involved in all of those things. Priests raping children and getting away with the rape of children, predation on the children. priests are also psychiatrists. They're the same thing. They both lice the mind and teach the children that they're the bad ones and not the pedophiles. It's nice to see they're going to be held accountable. CNN breaking news, Ebola vaccine, human tests could begin as early as September, National Institutes on Health say. And that is good because all of the general council members, like in Sierra Leone, they're all sick now. I guess they had told two of their doctors to release this stuff on the populace, on humanity. And these doctors, before they could do that, they ended up, I guess, spilling it out on themselves or whatever happened. But they're both dead now. And I guess the whole of the general council is under quarantine in Sierra Leone. We'll keep everybody updated on that. Things are terrible. Heart-wrenching to see. There's a politician, an Ebola-infected American, is coming to the U.S. for treatment. Looks like, I don't know if they're going to stick him in Washington, D.C. or not, but I know apparently Washington, D.C. has been on lockdown. They've been going after this right to carry for politicians recently. They nailed a couple staffers, and they've got it going through the courts, asking the courts to protect them from being attacked. And of course now that the attorneys are the target of gunplay, they want gun rights taken away. Well, no. Last night on the Bo and Rocco show, I was listening, and you know, Bo pointed out that guns are a lot like hammers. Do you really want to ask for a gun ban when you could be beat to death by this same mob coming after you because you've been human trafficking? I mean, that question, I would love to hear a politician answer me that. You would really, really, really rather be pitchforked to death? And here you are, you're banning guns now through your courts trying to protect yourself, but it's probably going to be more painful what happens to you. Bloomberg CIA apologizes for searches of Senate computers. July 31st, on today's roundup, Trish Regan, Olivia Stearns, Corey Johnson, and Eric Chamie wrap up the day's top market stories on Bloomberg Television Street Smarts. Might be an interesting one. I'll have to go listen to that one. It's been an interesting week. Israel and Hamas agreed on unconditional 72-hour humanitarian ceasefire to begin on Friday morning, U.S. and UN say. It's from breaking BBC news. Looks like they're playing games. We'll see what happens. Why are they not agreeing to perpetual eternal happiness? Because it's not conducive to business, right? It's conducive to business if they cease fire for a couple days and traffic arms and human beings to each other in between. How about you nail them for corrupt activity? Organized commercial enterprise here under the perpetual union. This is organized crime. You've got to open your mind here. For some reason, you all are patronizing it, calling it a government. It's organized crime. It is nothing less than organized crime. In Black's Law Dictionary, Confederacy is defined as, quote, a criminal enterprise. And the very last line of the definition says, see federal government. I do not know how to make that any more simple or palatable. You are either going to hear that, or you are not. It's just, it's profound. That we would tolerate such things, okay? So you've heard this. It's a criminal organization. Stop it. Get out of the criminalization, or you will be held accountable for being within the criminal organization. That's it. End of story. There are no more options. Crazy train ends here. Johnson & Johnson is withdrawing a surgical tool that can spread cancer in women, according to the Wall Street Journal. I'm calling out for an internal audit to ensure the safety and well-being of humanity on Johnson & Johnson, Dow Chemical Corporation, Kraft Foods, Hellmann's, and Beatrice Food Corporation. Because by the evidence so far, you all are perpetrating genocide. That one corporation, in many parts, happens to be the fund management team organized to human traffic human beings that are injured by their products. Hellmann's, Best Foods, Kraft, Johnson & Johnson, and Dow Chemical Corporation are the same entity. You remember asbestos, Dow Chemical Corporation. Aaron Brockovich, I think it was. Beatrice Foods Corporation. That's the same Hellmann's, the same Kraft, same Beatrice Foods, same Dow Chemical Corporation, as it always has been, killing people. By the evidence. They are perpetrating genocide, fund managing when their actions result in reactive disorders and diagnosis upon human beings. Now, the longer this goes on, the more will be made evident until you are no longer perpetrating these things upon humankind. I do not come on here to hear my head rattle. I don't like the sound of my own voice. Now, we want to mitigate damages. It's been a question asked recently. Yes, stop what you're doing. And get away from it. Whatever you've done in the past, you will be held accountable for. But it won't be as bad if you continue doing it with knowledge. So if you've never intentionally harmed a human being with knowledge, you are not held accountable for those things, correct? But if you are directing harm to come upon human beings, you will be held accountable for these things. Indoctrinating human beings, you will be held accountable for these things. Breaking human beings in any manner, using pedagogy or education upon them, you will be held accountable for these things. It's not a question of if it ever happens, it's happening. That's something that's been the most amazing for me to actually witness, is it apparently you have your heads in your rectum. Jesus says, I come like a thief in the night. That means he's already there and around you. You are not looking. You are being cannibalized by your peers. If you are innocent, get away from the thing. I don't like collateral damage. I don't like collateral damage in any way. If you're innocent, get away. banner on Westminster Bridge and the Queen's Park today, London, UK. Stop arming Israel. Beautiful picture at Westminster. Beautiful picture at Westminster. AMC talks for BBC America's stake allow London to keep control of the US network. Bloomberg News, 47 minutes ago. It's profound. Oh, more space shuttle stuff. Got, yeah. Alien bid for T-Mobile is only the latest bull gamble for one of France's richest men. It's an interesting use of language there. We'll see how that goes. Christie dodged by pension protests on eve of another New Hampshire visit. Scaring you. They want you to fight for your pensions. Pensions are not good. You don't want to fight for a portion of your inheritance. You want to be the heir. Don't buy into it. This is put out as propaganda by the nation. Should be held accountable for those things. This propaganda has been made unlawful. U.S. officials warn Americans not to travel to the three West African countries hit by an outbreak of Ebola. The Associated Press, 46 minutes ago. We gotta watch that, folks. If you come in contact with any member of General Counsel, please call your doctor. Make sure that you're not passing that stuff around. So if you're a GAL, pedophile, predator of children, and you've had exposure to any member of the General Counsel, you need to visit your doctor immediately to ensure that you do not have Ebola. You can find anywhere information on Ebola. Terrible, terrible, terrible disease. Apparently there's patents on it. Congress is bankrupt and it cannot receive any profit or royalty off of its former patented products. That includes FRNs and various patented things such as marijuana, Ebola, smallpox, and related. Those things are no longer for sale anywhere. No longer a part of commerce. Marijuana grows naturally in the ground. It's not a patented product. And look what happens when you give Ebola out to keepers of it. It's in the hands of General Counsel doctors who end up killing themselves and sickening a whole populace of General Counsel of their own doing, their own genocide. How is it possible to be that stupid? Revelation says you're stupid, but I didn't believe it until I saw it with my own eyes. You are stupid. You know, the truth really does set you free. Doesn't matter how ignorant I ever was, or naive I ever was. I was never stupid. I learned everything I am from the truth. And that disallows stupidity of this magnitude. Handling that stuff. Handling Ebola virus, for Christ's sake. And now there's two doctors dead And the whole of the United States and General Counsel is sick. That kind of biological warfare should not be in the hands of anybody. Destroying that thing is the cure to Ebola outbreaks. And destroying smallpox is the cure to smallpox outbreaks. Anthrax is the same. They're not to be kept anywhere. Why would you want to keep something that can be employed or used upon another life? Just the thought of those things alone is just absolutely horrifying. You want your own extinction? Let me get this straight here. You're so concerned over money that you don't mind going extinct. That is asinine. Asinine. You shouldn't be allowed to hold any kind of office. You shouldn't be anywhere near a courthouse or a medical industry of any kind, hospital, I don't care what it is. If you're stupid enough to give yourselves Ebola, you don't have any business being around humanity. You are a threat. Sick. Sick. You guys are insane. Never seen anything so appalling or abhorrent. Besides war, I mean, that can always be tactical, but this just is the icing on the cake. You shouldn't be allowed to walk without wearing a helmet. God. Buried a ship under the World Trade Center. Ship remains found beneath World Trade Center site, traced to Colonial Times, NBC News. It's always been the case. Congress does what it does, and then it hides all the evidence, destroys things by volcanic activity, or earthquakes, or tsunami, or tornadoes. It destroys all the evidence of its works. And then it says, oh my goodness, I've been injured. We need to get the federal emergency management going on here. And around and around and around and around it goes. The Red Cross picks up prisoners of war. You know what kind of burden that is? I had to take over the Red Cross, of course. And now, we're expending all of these monies on saving the General Counsel from itself. This is twisted. I hate General Counsel. But I cannot lawfully just watch another human being slaughter itself. So it's my obligation to pick them up using the Red Cross to put them into hospital settings. Those are all of the rules and written by all of the prophets. It doesn't matter who it was. Those are all of the rules. We're not allowed to let anything die. It's not good. Attorney General Holder says condemned should know what's in the drugs that will kill them. NBC News. Now, these lethal injections are the same thing that you're consuming through prescriptive sources. Psychiatrists are your executioner. Oh, I don't know how else to explain that one, but I asked you to read Psychiatrists, The Men Behind Hitler, over and over and over again. It says it all in there. It says it'll teach you that everybody's insane and they should be doped up. And then I provided other evidence, such as Aldous Huxley's speech to Stanford regarding the new revolution and human beings being subjected to some theory and all of these things whereby they'll just be compliant. All of that evidence is out there. I'm glad to see that this stuff is coming out into the open. They do talk about transparency. They don't name the drugs. They don't name the drugs. Now, as we watched in Ohio and elsewhere, these drugs are bennies. Benzodiazepine, Valium, Xanax, Haldol, Demerol, Oxycodone, Oxymorphone. These are things that shut down your body. Now the attorneys here, Attorney General Holder, is calling out that the condemned should know lethal drugs. Absolutely. They're called prescription medications. All of them. They all have side effects. Those are business ventures. The side effects of a prescription create a market condition. If it makes you sick, there's a market for that, for the cure. Prescription, writing before you are, it's prescribing you. It says it's engineered to cause a specific reaction. Stop taking them. Stop consuming them. Stop. 42 females a day are dying of prescription drug overdoses in the United States Incorporated alone. Every day. This is unacceptable. Intolerable. Those are my children. These are doctors prescribing death and selling it as an innocuous thing. These are lethal drugs. So it needs to be all put on the table, Mr. Holder. The Attorney General of the United States Incorporated. Now this will occur immediately. These things will stop. Here you are, the Attorney General, NBC News. You're saying, hey look, I have knowledge that these drugs are lethal and lethal to use against humanity. Now if your corporation continues to sell or promote those lethal drugs, you will be held accountable. Because you are saying you and your state, your foreign state, your corporation, has knowledge that those drugs are lethal. You cannot point the fingers at the FDA, which is under you. It's you. Now you shut it down. I will for you. These things are no longer tolerated in any way, shape, or form. We're talking about humanity here and the action of genocide. And it is nothing less. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. You're going to have to put on your big boy pants and take some accountability. This is enough is enough. It's disgusting, absolutely horrifying. Every day I'm horrified. These things are sick, they're horrifying. State Senator here in Denver, it looks like. Prosecutors charged Colorado State Senator Steve King for his role in several alleged crimes. They say the state senator, who represents Mesa County and part of Garfield County, was involved in embezzlement of public property, forgery, theft, and official misconduct. He could face jail time if he's convicted. Wait a second, bring forth the evidence. then he does face jail time. We don't play under private acts and acts of commerce. We don't play attorney work product doctrine. Get that evidence up there on the table. You measure. And that measure is the accountability. Did you harm a human being? Yes or no? Did you do this with intent? Prior knowledge? Yes or no? There's nothing else. There is nothing else. Where truth is, fiction of law does not exist. It's just like crazy. Donnie used to say that. Did you fall down and hit your head? Seems you're crazy. Did you fall down and hit your head or something? Here you are slaughtering humankind, and you want me to mitigate those things? Sick. You fell down and hit your head if you think that. These things are it's profound. You know, you would think that you would be smarter. And apparently that's not the case. It's very, very disheartening to see. You know, I was talking to everybody today. It's very, very lonely walking this walk because I don't have anybody to play with. There is absolutely no competition. Come in and show me a competition. When I'm winning hands down, I get very pissy. That's pitiful. This is a very, very lonely walk. Extremely. Alright, so sad because, you know, there's all of us out here doing this, but then where's everybody else? Because right now, I'm lonely. It's very, very empty and quiet. You guys never have an argument. You know, you're known by your works and actions. But you want to mitigate this. You want to whine and carry on and stuff. And I don't like the dance. The dance and stuff, the dog and pony shows, they do nothing for me. They're not entertaining for me. I'm entertained by the accountability part. It gets very lonely. Show me some accountability. That's what I enjoy. I don't enjoy watching Jesus get crucified. I enjoy watching Barabbas get crucified. He's the murderer. He's the one that's supposed to be on that cross. He's the one that's written on that cross. These things are, you know, carrying on the way that you're doing is just embarrassing. Absolutely embarrassing. I was talking to somebody today, and it's shameful, embarrassing. You know, you walk around with all these egos, but then you can't even defend your ego. You're lost. I've never seen anything like this. It's like Open Season, that cartoon. I love Open Season. Where the prey becomes the predator. It's a good cartoon. From BusinessInsider.com today, U.S. restocks Israel's ammunition supplies hours after condemning attack on a U.N. school in Gaza. Want me to repeat that one? The U.S. restocks Israel's ammunition supplies hours after condemning the attack on a UN school in Gaza. Shame on you, John Kerry. Shame on you for perpetrating war, civil war, war crimes. Shame on you, Congress. General Counsel. When you're all better from your Ebola outbreak, you can sure as bet that you're going to be up for trial here. You might want to be praying for your deaths, because when I'm done with you, it's not going to feel as good as Ebola. I can guarantee you this. These are six things. Six twisted things you've been doing to humanity. Now, if you survive Ebola, you're up for grabs. It's interesting to see that Iliad one. I haven't read that one yet, so I'll wait until probably tomorrow night. America's House of Representatives has authorized its speaker to sue Barack Obama. Let me tell you a little bit about John Boehner. John Boehner is the Speaker of the House. Congress is run by the President of the Senate, which is Joseph Biden. Barack Obama is a president. He's only a mouthpiece. Joseph Biden is puppet master. Always has been. That indoctrination program he's got running there. Violence Against Women Act. He was a victim of domestic violence perpetrated by females when he was a little boy. In his house, he said it was like a regime. He got the shit kicked out of him by females when he was little. He grew up to turn against his own race, which is humanity, for a buck. Violence Against Women Act allows female and child sex trafficking through the court system, through the FBI, through the airports, through CBS, through the IRS. All of these mechanics in this machine are to prey on women and children. The males are logical. They don't buy into politics until she sells it to them. She sells it after a long run-in with fourth-generation warfare, low-intensity conflict, which are both war crimes. War criminals are to be held accountable for psychological warfare, biological warfare. I'm not claiming, any damages. I already evidenced those things. You're perpetrating genocide, human trafficking, through congressional actions. Don't get a trial. Did I get a trial before you picked me to terrorize? You don't get a trial. You've already evidenced your works. These corporations, sick. Man, there's a lot of stuff today. Too much going on. A lot of false headlines too. I'm looking at studying weather on Mars. It's interesting today from the Washington Post. 2020 rover will study weather in preparation for possible human trips in the future. It's interesting. 1 minute ago, Sierra Leone declares a state of emergency and calls in troops to quarantine Ebola victims. Oh, look at what you guys did. Oh, come on, this is sick. The general counsel had directed its doctors to drop Ebola on the human populace. They ended up having a whatever mishap. And those two doctors are killed, and all of general counsel is under quarantine. I don't know how long an Ebola quarantine should last before it's eradicated. These things, you know, general counsel is just stupid. Absolutely stupid. Wall Street Journal is announcing American families are relying less on loans to pay for college study fines. That sounds really nice. You know, there's so much education out there that you can get without having to buy your stairway to heaven. These things are very important for you to realize. You don't need to seek a title. You want to have all knowledge. Sure as heck don't want to seek a title, because then you end up defending a title rather than defending yourself and each other. And that's how attorneys prey on humanity as a whole. It relies on defensive title and teaching you to be a thing. Acting as to the ego, the super ego, and the it. Those are all psychologically created. Stroking an ego does not feed you. It doesn't sustain you in any way. It is not your body. It's not relative to you. Psychological warfare upon you. Drop your ego. Get over yourself. And that was something that offended me years ago, but it was so funny. After I got over being offended, I realized, what the heck? I was offended. If I'm offended, I was carrying an ego. Now I'm not offended. I'm pissy because my children are being destroyed right before my eyes. When I had an ego, I couldn't see that. I was worried about me dying. Not about the world. Not about my children. And that's something that was the most beautiful of my journey. Doesn't matter how painful something is. Sometimes these painful things are absolutely profound and they're necessary for our ascension. And I couldn't ever have gotten rid of the majority of the things that were on my shoulders without ascending. You have to think higher sometimes. Forbes is then announcing student debt levels have been $1.2 trillion, FRNs, a burden that surpasses even U.S. household credit card debt. Aw, we need to just forget that then. Just get rid of it. We've got new product that, you know, it's producing for general welfare, and we're doing pretty good. We don't need the stuff that comes with selling Hippocrates his license. For money. Now, if you go back into the writings of Plato and Protagoras, in Protagoras, the discourse, it speaks all about Hippocrates. He just bought his license. He didn't know anything about medicine. He just paid some money and he got a title. That's not how relativity is. That's not how reality is. That's just commerce. Hippocrates wasn't the father of all medicine. Galen was. Going to that guy, he's the father of all indoctrination. Alias Galen. Galen of Pergamum. You can find different representations of him throughout writings. Everything is written, nothing's hidden. You know, you just gotta know where to look, or you want to look, seek it. If you want to know something, seek it, knock, and the door will open. It's simple. If you never knock on that door, it's not gonna open. So you're not at the door. Go knock on the door. It's very simple. It's not some mystical, you know, representation. These metaphors. Meta means self. Metaphor means knowledge. It's metaphors that are written for you, describe you. You can take up these titles. This is your relative walk. Huffington Post is Presenting hospitals are supposed to be for healing. In Gaza, they're part of the war zone. Thank you for pointing that out, Huffington Post. It's nice to see maybe Ariana might be coming around and kind of be patronizing a new father rather than the previous landlord there that was promoting such horrifying things. Half of 8 hours per week saved on household chores since 1965 going to parenting. Don't do that. Don't do that. You're shuffling your children off to other parents, but those are your children. You want them to have your constitution. They're little yous. You know, and humanity is more clan-like. We all stick around each other. We love each other. We're not really nomadic. Before, we were stuck in the northern hemisphere, so it's freaking cold. You know, we had the garden before it was taken over by attorneys and general counsels. It's not cold there. We never had to leave it until we were kicked off a general counsel. Back then it was described as the Council of Nicaea. You can also see this in the Levites, in the written text. You can also see this in Saul of Tarsus' walk. Paul, he's a Levite, a tax man. He went around grabbing stuff and telling people they owed him for it. Kind of like the Nutball King and Monty Python's representation of that kind of crap. Clapping his coconuts together. We're up on break. We'll be right back, folks. Stick around. Welcome back to the second hour of Leaving the Farm right here on Revolution Radio, freedomslips.com, where information never sleeps, as well as TammyPepperman.org. We are listener and reader supportive, and if you'd like to donate, please visit us at our sites, TammyPepperman.org or freedomslips.com, and click on our support pages. Every little bit helps. Of course, we're broadcasting tonight on No Borders Radio. It's brought through the Tamworth Web Development. If you'd like to donate, that's what's keeping us here. I've had to think about many, many, many things recently, and one of those is the nuclear power plants. And it's all of this crazy construct of, you know, simplified versions of energy or whatever you're claiming. I decided after watching the general counsel give itself Ebola recently that nuclear power plants are not going to be in their hands either. These entities, general counsel is absolutely insane. It's evidenced itself to be insane. And on top of that, as an infant, it's my obligation to pick it up and save it from itself. Regardless of how I feel about general counsel, it must be protected from itself. And in that, it must be protected from ability to harm humanity as well. And so I'm going to take all of these things, the nuclear power plants and nuclear technology and all of these WHO buildings and whatever else, and we'll deal with it as we go along. We'll just call it internal audits or whatever we're going to call it. But I know by the evidence, the general counsel cannot handle control over these things, as they can't even handle themselves and each other. And that being said, I could care less if you're offended. You know, you can petition our courts if you need anything. You know, if you have a disagreement or you're not in agreement with United States public law. You can come into our courts and you know, a judge will be happy to assist you. The courts will be happy to assist you in petitioning for relief of whatever you think that you're owed, because I took away your ability to harm yourself or others. That's like, you know, calling 911 because you killed somebody wrongly, rather than because you killed somebody. It's silly. You're silly. And again, by the evidence, I'm required to protect you under the laws of infants. It says if something's harming itself, parens patrae says I can step in and be your parent for you. You're going to be out there trying to kill other people and then ending up committing suicide yourself and costing me a bunch of money. Who do you think is funding now the Red Cross to be there picking you up? That irritates me more than anything. The general counsel is the enemy of mankind. And now here I am, picking up the general counsel and making sure that it's safely on its way. Now, I don't like doing these things. I don't like seeing anything, any entity dying. This is wrong. I like life. I like life. I love life. And, it doesn't matter how much money you have. Our Red Cross will pick you up. And, make sure that you're safe from yourself and the ability to harm others. That's what it's all about. Humanity. Running helps has been reported. Everybody's supposed to be resting by now. And I'm irritated by this stuff in Israel. Are they not being fined enough? Have they not enough charges to stop? So for every day, just treat it like any other sovereign state, because my humans are there. Until I have evidence that there's no more human beings being preyed on in Israel, in the Gaza Strip, or anywhere for that matter, I'm going to be held accountable for genocide against humanity. For each one of your acts, I don't care what it is. You know, Russia's saying, well, we can't afford this. Okay, then you shouldn't have hurt anybody. You should not have harmed human beings. If I have to act like a disappointed parent, that's ridiculous. Grow up. My goodness, you're killing each other and you're killing my children. All for what? Things. As you act as these infants. That's the evidence of depravity. Bankruptcy. That's what depravity is. It's a bankrupt state. It doesn't hold anything. It cannot receive royalties. Cannot receive any revenue until its creditors are paid back. I haven't been paid back yet. Humanity is not on general welfare yet. I know that it's happening here and there. I'm watching it play out. It's not fast enough. Come on. Human beings are going to rest now. I'm not going to wait on this one. I'm not playing games. I told you what the rules are. When I get the children back, when the children are all at their well-being on general welfare, then I stop. I stop my efforts against you. Because then you're not perpetrating any more crimes. So stop perpetrating these crimes, and I will stop charging you for these crimes. But I cannot do that until you stop perpetrating the crimes. And that means that I follow you wherever you go until such time as you decide to stop perpetrating these crimes against humanity. You act on consensus reality. That's something that is very, very profound to see. As a game theorist, I only act upon the truth. That's it. When you're acting in consensus reality, again, where truth is, fiction of law does not exist. That thing that you hold up as a shield is pretend. You are imagining it. It is consensus reality. You're holding up a cartoon as a shield in front of you and hoping that it works at some future date and time when you're caught. No, it doesn't work like that if you look around. You are witnessing with your own eyes cannibalism. Stop being criminals. I don't want peace. I want the well-being of humanity. That's it. That's the bottom line. That's the only thing there is. The absolute. That's the truth. Humanity will be well. I'm not negotiating. I don't negotiate with terrorists. Not a part of a criminal organization. Not a part of a confederacy or league or association or united, whatever the heck. I do not negotiate with terrorists. There are no other options other than to adhere to the public law. If you do not want to adhere to the public law, which simply means do no harm, you will be held accountable. It's very sad to see. Very sad to see that you want to go certain routes and directions that are not conducive to your own preservation. As infants. Because you're not considering your own well-being. You're not able to take care of yourself, let alone others. Okay, I've said that I don't know how many times. I don't like collateral damage. If you are innocent, get away from that thing. It's terrifying for me to see these things. As you tear each other and render each other within the action of political cannibalism. It's vicious. It's like watching hyenas at the feet. I don't like seeing those things. It's not fun for me. I enjoy holding you accountable. I don't enjoy seeing it. It's yucky. Reed F. Richardson is reporting. SSCI report will show CIA fed media lies to push pro-torture propaganda. Time to prosecute the leakers. The leakers! Let me tell you something. Because Dianne Feinstein, senator, is the chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee. These are the folks that direct the CIA. That feed the CIA artificial intelligence, and then the CIA is as a mouthpiece for that intelligence. It's a production company. But the playwrights, the scriptwriters, are Senate and the House of Representatives. So, Mr. Richardson. Mr. Richardson, read F. Richardson. Calling out for the persecution of the innocents. It's not conducive to your well-being. Dianne Feinstein being the director of the CIA is accountable for the works of the directed. What was interesting for me to realize and evidence myself was not only that I had to serve everything in the case upon these freakish creations, but because I realized by the evidence, of course, as it's written in 1 Corinthians 13, that if I do that, find out who's for and who's against me. Because if they're against me, I'm about to be whacked. It was very interesting in my own journey. Find out who's for and against humanity. And it wasn't from the directed. I read portions of things recently from John O'Brien on previous CIA quote directors, which were only the office, the title of director. And he watched all of these things occur, the 9/11 and the terrorism and the fear porn that was promoted upon humanity. And you have innocents that are in such states of fear that they would be willing to torture another. It's horrifying, but those states of fear were created by the initial directors promoting this artificial intelligence. Now, and we need to hold only the actors accountable for their works. Because if somebody's acting on the directives or another, or if they're fed an educational program that is not the truth, and they act on it, yes, limits the culpability, mitigates, of course. And we want to get to the absolute truth in all things, by which we can be measured. And these measurements are very, very important in all things. That is accountability. It's an equal measure to what we put out. Whatever we do upon the earth, so shall be loose upon us in heaven. If you've perpetrated such horrifying things of your own hands with knowledge and intent, why, you're going to be held accountable at an equal measure. We all have the same journey, we all have the same questions, we all have the same forces upon us. And that one I've meditated on an awful lot. Because years ago I asked myself what brought me to this place or this space. What brought me here? Why am I here and why is nobody else here? Or why am I here and why are there others here that are not the same as me. Now I'm in these meditations. You have found, and I have found, that there is absolutely a very narrow gate. The truth goes right through there. Goes right through an eye of a needle quicker than a camel, that is for sure. It's very interesting what one gleans when they open themselves up to experiencing everything. I'm not happy about a lot of the experiences that I've been through, but they taught me a lesson each one. And so regardless of the pain, I am thankful for every experience. As if we can avoid them in others, and then there is no more pain. If all it takes is one of us to experience these things, well then one of us might volunteer. And then the rest of us don't have to suffer. As long as we learn from each other. And that's what Hesiod said. Hesiod was a very profound poet. Very profound. Things are very, very interesting. Always, in all things, we learn every day. It's a very, very profound journey, and we already read about Steve King. We have many things. Everything seems to have fallen by the wayside. You know, today I was listening to Talking Heads Burning Down the House. I think that was a fitting one. We read about the U.S. restocking. Bo came out with a short this week on Bono's Entertainment called The Gelnhausen Effect. I thought it was so profound. I really loved his... the way that one was produced, and of course it's he and I in audio, and I really like that one. Judge is arrested for stealing bail, child support money suspended without pay, will remain behind bars. Sorry, just loading. Let's see, this is on Costa Rica, so that's pretty, InsideCostaRica.com. And it says that a judge has been arrested for stealing bail and child support money, July 29th. Criminal court judge Inapala Aloela, identified by the last name Leon, who was arrested last Thursday on charges that he stole bail and child support funds, has been suspended without pay. Court also ordered that Leon remain in preventative detention for 3 months while prosecutors prepare their case. According to official investigation, in October of last year, a criminal defendant posted bail of $2 million. I'm not sure. That one looks like the old peso, the little amount of gold, I think. Peseta symbol. So they were shaking down, getting gold out of this guy. So the little symbol on InsideCostaRica.com, it looks like the peseta, which is a small amount of gold, like the old peso from Italy. I wonder if they're, it's interesting. Apparently delivered in cash to the judge. So the judge is accepting lawful money here for in exchange for shaking somebody down. Prosecutors say the judge did not deposit the funds to the state, but apparently pocketed the money instead. That's a bad one. That's 2 million. I think those are ounces of gold, because the old peseta, the Italian lawful equivalent to the lawful dollar. I'll find out more later, but Costa Rica, that's funny. IRS is located there. Or used to be. Until it was taken over by the United States, lowercase. Interesting. At least 22 dead, 270 hurt in Taiwan gas explosion. Toll expected to rise. It's terrible. I was watching this earlier, and you can't tell. So the death toll is rising in Taiwan in a series of explosions triggered by underground gas leaks in the southern region, in the southern city of Kaohsiung, according to state-run news agency CNA. At least 22 people were killed and another 270 injured when the powerful blast ripped through the city's sewage system early Friday. Firefighters from neighboring cities rushed to Kaohsiung to help battle the flames, CNA reported. The government also called up hundreds of soldiers to assist rescue efforts. Our hearts go out to these, it took them 7 hours to report this one. It's interesting. I don't know. Get that back in Japan one other time before, but they were working for a criminal enterprise back then. That one's up in the air. Flair Systems invented a case for Apple's iPhone with thermal imaging capabilities. Nah, we're going to put our foot down here. We don't need to be using that kind of thing. There's no purpose for it in relativity or reality of any way. Why would we want to facilitate thermal imaging? Give me your, your pitch, I guess. I don't see a use for it. Let me know of your ideas and whether or not there is absolutely any potential to harm human beings. And let me see that, and we'll see what we're going to do here. New York mayor forges Wall Street ties to provide $300 million, those are your fines, in affordable housing loans. There's another actions, hearts and minds, as Andrew Cuomo tries to buy himself out of the sticky situation he found himself in when he realized corrupt activity, subpoenaed some information, found out that it was him, and stopped all prosecution, just like Charles Manson would do if you asked Charles Manson to determine whether or not he murdered Sharon Tate and an unborn child. Now, do you think that's a good idea, my infants, or do you think that's a bad idea? We're not going to tolerate those types of things any longer. Andrew Cuomo is a criminal. And he spoke this in his own hand just recently when he found corruption within his own office, which is under directions of himself, Andrew Cuomo, the governor, with the authority to direct his own office. And he finds some corrupt activity, swears out a subpoena, and then finds out that it's him, and then drops the prosecution. Okay, somebody pick it up here. Our law enforcement is required to pick this up here because he found corruption for us, presented the evidence, and then tried to tamper with the evidence. You see where I'm going here, right? I mean, this is ridiculous. No more waiting. He's a criminal. I don't care what kind of picture he's got up. I mean, this is ridiculous. That was on Bloomberg. Thank you, Bloomberg, for pointing these things out. And ensuring state security. This kind of thing can't go on. We've got to light them up. Light them up. The media and Revelation, of course, our angels, said to be the candlesticks. There's 7 of them. Those things light the way, don't they? They were never, ever, ever supposed to be under the governorship of the Broadcasting Board of Governors run by John Kerry. What the heck is that kind of twisted thing? No? Those things are yucky. I mean, it says right in Revelation this will occur. Running for as little as 5 minutes a day helps your health. I used to love to run. Love running. Love playing. Love playing in the mud. This is in the New York Times. Love getting dirty. Love the smell of outside. I want to be outside. I don't want to be doing this crap all the time. You know, and if I didn't have to hold predators accountable, I'd be outside playing. Let me go play. Let's hold them all accountable all at once. Let's save us some time here. Figure it out. Simplify. Do whatever needs to occur. But we need to rest now. Humanity has had enough. Humanity has had enough pummeling. It's been suicided and genocided and murdered enough. It's time to stop now and go on forward with life and be living. It is not the time to wait around and wait for whatever to occur. I don't know what everybody's waiting for, but it's time for humanity to be well. Period. Not teaching anymore. When we're done teaching, we're going to start putting this stuff into effect so that humanity can be well. Not going to sugarcoat anything. I'm not going to allow you to hide your heads in the sand any longer, because you cannot afford to do that. That is not conducive to your well-being. It's time for you to realize, wake up, get over yourself, put on your big boy and big girl pants. I know it looks dark. It says that in 1 Corinthians 13. It says it's time to put on your big boy pants on here. And see through that glass darkly. That means, yes, it hurts. It hurts your feelings for a short amount of time. But the overall reward is just absolutely astounding. When humanity is no longer being preyed on, that is heaven. That is when there's no stress, there's no depression. When that which is perfect is come, nothing else is parted out. I don't have to be here, and you don't have to listen to my voice anymore. I'm scratchy. My throat gets so tired, and it sounds so terrible. Don't make me talk anymore. I want to shut up now. It says in 1 Corinthians 13, as soon as I follow these rules and everything else, my tongue gets to stop. I want my tongue to stop. Everybody has their choice. I have the knowledge that they require to make a decision. Make the decision. No more. I'm not waiting around. You know, if I have to choose for you, because your evidence, your works and actions, evidence to me that you enjoy that kind of lifestyle, that is what you will get. That's what you want. You are choosing that. It's also written, Matthew 10. I didn't get due process. You got every notice. Because at inception, you know the difference between harm. You know that you don't like to feel pain. Don't cause it upon another. If it hurts you, it hurts another. Don't do that. You already know better. I don't have to wait around for you to make up a story or justify why you perpetrated a harm upon a human being, because you know better already. If you have harmed a human being, you will be held accountable right now. It's not funny. You know, you're facing extinction on both ends now. not only humanity that's being wiped out by psychopathy, but psychopathy just let loose Ebola on itself. How is that conducive to life? What the heck are you doing chasing those dollars? Sick. It's twisted. It's like living in a nightmare. Make it go away. Stop doing these stupid things. So we're going to start testing on by September, but pretty sure that we need to quarantine them as long as it takes to not spread Ebola across the damn globe. It's dangerous. Don't leave until there is no Ebola. Don't let it out or let it loose and then warn people it's coming. Do that and I will hold you accountable for genocide. Not funny. If I catch you using Ebola as an excuse to quarantine humanity, human beings of any kind, you'll be rewarded 10 times 10. If you pretend to act in my name, you'll be rewarded 10 times 10. That'll be coming of the second death. You'll pray. You could die. I don't like death. I don't like that. General welfare requires productive psychopaths. Doesn't require dead ones. I don't want dead psychopaths. That doesn't do me any good. You guys are trying to commit suicide using Ebola. If you infect humanity, I'm going to come after you and hold you accountable for that stuff. That's sick. Stop doing those things. Foul. Absolutely abhorrent. Sick. It's hard to get over that one. I can't forgive something like that. That's disgusting. You guys are horrifying. Ridiculous. Department of Defense, Jamaican team rode a raft during Farza's commando test. I don't know. Let's go see what that is. Because hopefully, going to protect the general counsel that was so damn stupid. You know, we've got the supposed to be out there closing ceremonies. No, it looked like a parade or something. There was just a serious electrocution of a Colombian paratrooper during closing ceremonies. Tolomeda. Hope he's okay, says Daniel Hernandez. This is some kind of competition. According to the Minister of Defense in Colombia, it's all being produced. You guys get out of there, man. United States Incorporated once slaughtered an entire populace and blamed it on Pol Pot. These treaties and agreements and peace compacts they have with each other. These are murderous individuals. Get them out of there. It's disgusting. Better not be any human casualties in there. Better be, you know, your entities and the stuff that you have control over, because I don't want to see any more human deaths. It's impossible here to get this point across to you. They, you know, other people were laughing about, you know, you have this opportunity to go away and be accountable in various ways other than, you know, being rubbed on a psychopath-sized cheese grater. I would take those opportunities, because the worst stuff you do and the worst it gets upon humankind, that's your equal measure. The other day, a senator, one of your own, rolled on you and said that you should be drowned like witches. That's not a good thing for you. Your senators are calling out for your debts. It's not good. Your father has forsaken you and laid you at the feet of somebody else's mercy. We know that Senate is your director. We would like to hold Senate accountable, but it keeps rolling on all of the little fall guys, and the fall guys are taking it. Don't be a fall guy. That's silly. It's silly. You're acting like agents. Acting like agents. You know, it's perpetual Eve all over everywhere. Seeing her roll over on Adam time after time again, and she never changes. Okay, once she's in it for the benefit and for the money, she's always in it for the benefit or the money. She's not there because she loves you. She strokes your ego. She makes your ego feel really good. She's got her claws in your back that whole time. You know, you can read about Eve, and you can read about Lilith, and you can read about Delilah. They're all the same. Judas. She's all the same character, different degrees. Sometimes Eve is absolutely just disgusting and horrifying, like Delilah. Delilah was asked by the judges to give the judges all of Adam's or Samson's information, the stuff that makes him tick, stuff that hurts him, how he feels about things. And that's what she informs on. Delilah is good at bringing down Samson's house, and it brings it down around his head, using the judges to do so. It's a wise thing to read up on Samson and Delilah, of course, and also on Job. I mean, that's the perpetual story of Job, of course, is Adam and Eve, and Samson and Delilah, and Judas and Jesus. All of these things are the same story, and it's relative to your walk. It's warned you about who you should hang out with and who you should not be hanging out with, and who you should trust and who you should not trust. And by now, you know, Eve is evidencing herself, and Delilah is coming out of the closet to evidence herself. But what I'm seeing is that Adam and Samson there and Jesus, you guys aren't listening. You're not believing your own eyes because you're chasing a piece of tail. And she's got you really blinded. And that is witchcraft. It's conjuring you. It's witchcraft. And to get you with law, conjure, to do stuff, why that's the practice of law, the practice of witchcraft. You need to watch out for the seducers. That's what she is. She's talked about a lot in the Bible. And the seducers, for example, come and, you know, attempt to promote the Pharisee, or the doctrine of the Pharisee at one point in time. And Jesus said, don't do that. And of course, the seducer, and I run into this every day talking to Eve and Delilah. As she's sitting there, oh, you just don't like me because I didn't bring you bread or I didn't donate. Excuse me? No, honey. And Jesus said the same thing. He says, I'm not mad at you because you didn't bring bread or you didn't donate to my cause. I'm mad at you because you're teaching the doctrine of the Pharisee. You're teaching man's law. You're not teaching God's law. And Jesus, of course, was very, very upset with the Sadducees and those that would seduce Adam or Samson or Jesus, all of these things. It's absolutely profound that she's been allowed to get away with these things for so long. And the other day I had a conversation with one of the Eves that called herself Eve. And then she called herself Helen. And I said, yeah, that's Achilles' heel. Same bruise on the heel, saboteur. That word comes from sabot, meaning wooden shoe. That's what she is. All she does is bruises your heel. She's your saboteur. Nothing. She garners your information as a human agent, human intelligence. She takes that information and feeds it to the judges, which are usually, you know, part and parcel to the E4s, general counsel, corporate counsel. Then they know how to make you dance by court process. They know what you're going to protect. They know what gets to you, and that's what makes you productive for Satan, the attorney, which is your adversary. She works for the attorney. This last week, we've called out for another round of shutting off these broker accounts. Pretty soon, you'll find that she'll just go nuts because we're cutting off her funding sources by which to turn on you. We don't like that informants are being paid to be informants, is that's not allowing free will, and she needs to be accountable for her own words. If she's not your responsibility, if she's not married to you and she's actually working for the state, that's evidencing that she's the responsibility of her husband under the rules of the exchequer. So when you're coming at me telling me and whining about Eve doing things to you, her paycheck is drying up, so ultimately this will lift the hell from your shoulders you find yourself in. But when they come for her, let her go. You know, if you try to protect her when her charges come upon her, or you hire an attorney to get her off of these charges, you're going to redistribute your estate. Don't do that. Just let her be charged and their own attorneys over there with her daddy's state and throw her to the wolves. She's not your responsibility. She's never been your wife. She's always been the wife of the state, and she's evidenced that by being an agent for the state. You know, it's very simple. These are the truth of things. And we don't act outside of the truth or within consensus reality, and I'm not going to sugarcoat it and tell you that your wife's been loving you all this time, because she hasn't. She hates you. She's in it for the money. She needs you for your sperm. She got your sperm. She used the courts to remove you from the ability to protect those children that were produced. And she does this with absolute efficiency on behalf of her father. Now, she is not the responsibility of humankind. That thing is not a human. She is the responsibility of Satan, her creator. No ifs, ands, or buts. There is nothing mitigating that. There is nothing that justifies that behavior. She's evidence to be the daughter of Satan. She's evidence to have been perpetrating harm against humanity, and she will be held accountable. And Satan is responsible for its child. Humanity is not responsible for Satan's children. Now, those bankrupt states must be rectified. Those monies are owed to humanity. They're not owed to Satan. Those things, you know, you must realize what you're seeing. All around, not just humanity, but also Satan and your children. Because you can make things easier on yourself by simply stopping the wars upon humanity. I don't like to see you suffer. I don't like to see anything suffering. I don't like collateral damage. And I would prefer that everything was just perfect. Well, it's not. Because Satan is still running around, and so are its children. As soon as that stops occurring, humanity will be well and at its well-being. And until then, this continues. Right? It's just sad. I feel like I'm just repeating myself now. I really don't like doing these things anymore. But again, until that horrifying thing is lifted off of the backs of humanity, I continue doing what I do until it's lifted, until it's over. This is an air tank. It's wasting my time, my life. It's just an absolute ridiculous thing that, man, there's so many things. And the stupid stuff with the Ebola virus, don't play with stuff like that. You know, Bo said it last night. Don't play with stuff like that. And he said it over and over and over and over again. That's crazier than a soup sandwich, he says. You're going to shoot your eye out with that thing. It gives you plenty of examples. Okay, if you can't handle something, don't touch it. Don't make it yours. Don't take it up as yours. And it can't hurt anybody. You know, if you can't handle something and you don't know what it's about, don't touch it. Leave it there. These things are so sad to see. This quarantine in Sierra Leone, that's a beautiful place, and now everybody's sick there. The General Council. Now, General Council can't be put out into humanity until we know for sure that it's not going to kill us with the Ebola virus. How's that working out for everybody? That's just sad. I think that we have better opportunities for healing in Boston General. I would like the Ebola victims in Sierra Leone transported to Boston General Hospital. And, you know, the United States will, of course, pay for this transport effort initially, but the charges have to go against the United States Incorporated for these things, because look at what they've done now to their own general counsel. And then I have to come in and play cleanup. That's not, that's sad. You know? I think that, you know, I'd like to see Japan help in this effort. I'd like to see Japan come in and help us and be our allies and other countries too. I want others to step up to the plate here and be our allies and stop these wars upon humanity. And if you have a hospital to offer, if you have any institution to place this psychopath, at least until we can control the outbreak of Ebola, because you know without a doubt that General Counsel is associated with not only Senate, they're also associated with the on the ground, corporate counsel, guardian ad litem, attorneys, judges, and all of these entities are possible carriers of the Ebola virus. I don't want the spread of Ebola to affect any more than it has already affected. This must be taken care of right now, immediately. And I would like to see some allies in this. And you know, because I did not create this situation. And until the United States Incorporated is able to pay what it owes the United States, we're going to have to pick up some of this and play cleanup. And the burden upon me right now is just so great, and I would love to be able to share this burden with others so that it's not so heavy, and we can get through this and stop the spread of Ebola before it goes any further. And of course, we're running out of time now, I think that should be first and foremost, is that the whoever's with me is with me. Whoever is against me is against me. And we'll see how this all works out and whether or not humanity is going to pull through. I think we're well on our way to a beautiful new day, as I learned yesterday and today. There's been a lot of light, a lot of light, and I am thankful in these things, regardless of stuff that's going on around us. I think that we have a better realization of what needs to be done and what is being done on what was and what will be. Well, we'll be here tomorrow night right here on TammyPepperman.org with Public Law with Bo and Tammy. Be well, everybody.